Director of the Department of Energy, Dr. Mark Bino, today announced that ExxonMobil has made its 10th discovery offshore Guyana at the Pluma 1 well. The well, which is located some 17 miles south of the Tarbert 1 well and follows previous discoveries on the Stabroek Block, encountered approximately 121 feet of high-quality hydrocarbon-bearing sandstone. The well was safely drilled to 16,447 feet depth in 3,340 feet of water. The Noble Tom Madden drill ship began drilling on November 1, 2018. Speaking to media operatives just hours before the announcement was made, Exxon Country Manager Ron Henson had this to say.
Very excited to have our 10th discovery in the Pluma well. This well encountered about 121 feet of hydrocarbon-bearing sandstone. This well is about 17 miles south of the Turbo discovery. So as we were talking about, and as we're sitting here at the Supplier Development Forum, it's important this discovery adds to the potential that will help these Guyanese investors to have the confidence to make the capital investments, to take some risks so that they can take advantage of these opportunities.
The precious recoverable resource estimate on the Stabroek Block was more than 4 billion barrels. This discovery reinforces the potential of the country being able to produce more than 750,000 barrels of oil daily by 2025, and to the potential for development in the southeast section of the Stabroek Block, since the Stabroek Block is 26,800 square kilometers. According to the ministry, the Noble Tom Madden is expected to begin drilling the Tilapia 1 prospect, located some 3.4 miles west of the Longtail 1 well. Meanwhile, the Stena Carbon drill ship has recently completed operations at Hammerhead 1 and will soon drill its next well following scheduled maintenance. Exxon and its affiliate, SO Exploration and Production Guyana Limited, is operator and holds 45% interest in the Stabroek Block. Hess Guyana Exploration Limited holds 30% interest and CNOOC Nexen Petroleum Guyana Limited holds 25% interest. Rupa Sinarayan, The Evening News.